challenge like no other. A journey that will reshape the future of energy. Mega structures, India's solar power.
Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. That was Adani Green for you. I am Wing Commander GRN Reddy. Happened to join Adani Green just 6 months back, looking after the O&M part of it. I have 9 solar sites under me with a portfolio of 340 megawatts. I'm the cluster head of Karnataka state northern region. Today's presentation I'll be covering under these heads. First, I'll talk about a brief about my company, the O&M philosophy that we follow, a brief comparative study, the challenges and the opportunities which exist in O&M, and before I conclude, a few recommendations, suggestions. This is it. As on date I stand before you, we have already commissioned 1778 megawatts of solar energy, and under the still under implementation is 230. That should meet our target of 2 gigawatts by this financial year end. And we are span over 9 states, 23 sites as on date. Additionally, we also have a facility of 1.2 gigawatt of module manufacturing facility at Mundra. Our core competency, as you see, stands with O&M. However, projects is also catching up because the kind of projects that we're implementing, and this is a data, a bit old data, so you can expect more from this in the from the project side as well. Coming to the complexity, as of now, as I said, within a short span of another 1 to 2 years, we look for 2 to 2.5 gigahertz. And number of sites as on date is 23. A wide plethora of technology, right from thin film modules to string inverters to seasonal tilt, robotic cleaning, and 9 states, as I said. And the plant size invariably varies from 10 megawatts to 648, or the Kamuti plant which you recently saw. That was primarily 45 minutes of National Geography video made for our company. This is the O&M philosophy that we follow. Operations, as you are aware, primarily takes care of the day-to-day activities and maintenance. Schedule maintenance and plant activities. I'll be dwelling upon this slide later on. O&M happens to be the source of value creation for the business. Revenues we need to increase by increasing the power of generation. And coming to cost cutting, primarily O&M happens to be cost cutting. We have a manpower which is on the roll as well as off roll. We try to have lean mean force as possible, and cost being effectiveness and, you know, management of materials, services and resources with a proper forecasting scheduling, and my work at CapEx to be as efficient as possible. We have a central team and our head office is located in Ahmedabad, and presently there are 3 regions. We intend to have the 4th region east, where we are not available right now to a great extent, and with the help, they are the experts sitting there, and they help us in, you know, they are domain experts who look after HV side, LV side, low voltage, inverters, especially some SCADA, switchyard, who assist the field units, the local sites, and through our renewable operations nerve center. This is the main crux of the thing which I am going to discuss with you, which we are coming up in a big way. Right now we are in a very short, it's in a small scale. The operating model, when it comes to the site versus the central team which assists us from the background, most of the operations take place at the site with, of course, support from the head office, where a lot of management, knowledge management takes place, the forecasting, scheduling, insurance, the warranty claims, the space management and the standardization of the space as such, generating reports, revenue management, command and control structure as a whole. These activities outsourced is under the close supervision of the on-roll manpower. Like primarily there are 3 parts of it, like the grass cutting, the module cleaning part, and in case there happens to be seasonal tilt, the tilting of the modules. And the non-core activities like the module, as I said, securities and admin are primarily outsourced to a third party. The renewable operations nerve center, as I said, is still in the nascent phase. And we intend to come out in a big way at the Gandhigram, at a Shantigram office in Gandhigram, Gandhinagar, sorry. This is how it's going to look like. And because technology is there and we are able, it's possible for us to have a micro, right, going up to the module level, string monitoring, everything is possible, so that we have lean force at the site itself, and the head office can always assist in the to the site personnel. The value proposition of RONC is something like this. You know, you can have a lot of integration. as it is possible, and information in real time, and how it is possible to even disseminate that on a mobile app. I'll be dwelling on that. I'll show you a snapshot. And generating real-time alerts to the user. There's a particular fault, you can go and attend to it. So there's a minimum wastage of time during the especially peak generation hours in the daytime. And analytics predicts, intelligence can be integrated into that. And any intervention which is required at the site, any help, can be easily extended from the head office. This is a screenshot of your mobile app that we propose, wherein you have real-time, what was the generation, what is the irradiation, including the weather factors, what is the particular module, inverters, how they are behaving. It's possible to have all this on the app. This is the structure that I was talking about, the zones, except for the east, north, west, south. And I'm just giving you an example of Karnataka, where the north Karnataka, I have 9 plants under me. There's another south cluster and a central one. This is basically for the ease of administration. If I were to compare a solar park with an individual site, because of a vast portfolio that we have, my personal feeling has been that it's easy to maintain a solar park. The ecosystem is so supportive, the knowledge sharing is there. The power evacuation is not much of a problem because you have your own competitors and you know they can help you out. The optimization of resources is there, unlike in a isolated site where you have you're more or a bit stretched. The regulatory body, the agency, they know what they are supposed to do. The month May or the month end when you have the joint meter reading, it's easy for us to conduct it. Unlike example from Karnataka where I say there are two agencies, one is the KPTCL and another is the DISCOM. So you need to get both of them on board and together they have to come and do, and these kind of issues are there, admin issues primarily. And thus, if you see the photograph that I'm showing you below is the solar ultra solar park of Gani. This is the one on the left. If you see, it's a contiguous land. However, when it comes to single sites, there are farmer issues. When you start, we think that we'll get a contiguous land, but it doesn't happen that way. So there are pockets of land. So this itself is a big hassle and bottlenecks in itself. So that's what I want to convey. And of course, the PPA in solar would be less, as I said, because of inherent advantages. Another comparison between a central to a string inverter. When it comes to a string inverters, basically we have 2-3% of, which is what we have found. Is generation is more, the availability of a string inverter is more because it's a high availability, and the MTDBF, if I got to talk to the mean time between repair and availability of the modular concept, basically I can go ahead and replace it as and when I want it. So not only that, even the switching on and shutdown of the MTD of a central inverter, correction, string inverter, is 30 minutes more. So I get to generate more because of that. Of course, auxiliary consumption is less, primarily because not only is this string inverter less expensive, but I can also afford to have a spares as a spare in a standby at my site. So in our case, as we have a cluster base, we also have it in cluster. So wherever it is required, we can just go ahead and it's a module replacement sort of thing. However, the disadvantage would be the monitoring is difficult. If I have to go to each inverter at particular site, the thousands of them would be there. But notwithstanding, because of the communications, the SCADA and OFC which we laid, it's possible to monitor where it's going to go, likely to go faulty or where it's faulty and can replace them. And next is the, once the warranty lapse, what about the OEM? If you were to stop particular model production or something like that, then that is an issue. And long-term effect, as we all know, it's a recently new evolving field, 25 years, who's seen that, so that could be a challenge. It all boils down to how you're going to use your innovative methods, or if I were to say Jugaad, or how you're going to go about reducing the O&M costs. So whether it's module killing, whether you're going to use a robotic arm, the water, which kind of technique you're going to use, how you're going to bring the cost down. The weather monitoring station we have, how are you going to effectively utilize that to predict your next day's weather or the today's generation, or how much could I have generated? The thermography, I'm going to show you a few more slides on this. The PV analysis, as you are aware, already there are people are there who are, I mean, the module, this is based on mobile ones. They can come and do the checking at site. So you know how the degradation is taking place. And coming to single axis or seasonal tracker, which kind of model would like to go ahead, depending on, of course, the cost, the area that you have, the PPA that you agreed with. The slide, this diagram which I want to show you is for a PPA of 4 rupees 34 paisa, if my cost of cleaning each module was 65 paisa, then where do I break even? What should be my cleaning cycle? So if you can see this, it comes to around fortnightly once, the cross which is getting cut. around 14th or 15th day. So I should be doing my cleaning approximately. That boils down to twice, the cycle of twice a month. In the month of November, we had carried out this drone survey. I think most of you must be interested in this because this is a Gani plant. It's an ultra-solar park. If you can see, it gives the kind of details which it can give. What is a fault? Exactly, if you see, it's a diode fault here. And exact location of the molecular module, it's in block number 2. The block, each block comprises of 5 megawatt. And this is another example of where the module has gone faulty because of reverse polarity. Could be at the time of installation or after repair. This is another case of a module failure. And the overall report of the plant when it gets generated is something like this. Here you can see for the block 2, that is 5 megawatt. Particular, there are like 10 blocks like this in 50 megawatt of a plant. The module failures quantity 6, module reverse polarity 4, and so on and so forth, and hotspot 182. Primarily meaning that this is where it is likely to go faulty or where we can expect certain faults. Coming to the risk and the challenges that we look forward, how is the module degradation? How are we going to factor this point? The spare supports, how are we going to cater for that, whether or not in the because of technology obsolescence, and whether or not we are able to efficiently manage the logistics part of it. Manpower cost is going to increase day by day, that's for sure. And whether how we're going to predict and utilize this factor to our best generation possible, because in the very near future, GISCOMs are going to ask us to predict the next day's generation as well. And of course, Mother Nature rules, and there's a photograph of Rajasthan where we had a hailstorm, and notwithstanding the heavy rains and the floods, these are all challenges. The game changer in the future would be who's the guy who does his work with the least cost per megawatt, and what are the various innovative ways you're going to come around. Let's say if you are to stop, minimize my grass cutting, how do I grow a weed? This is still in the nascent phase, we're just trying to work out, and if you can do that, it is good. What is the technology going to use for module cleaning? Rather than doing different things, it's better to do, how do you do the things differently? Training part, I won't like to dwell much upon this, but however, this does that. Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, there are a lot many training institutes that come up. They do give certifications as well. Coming to the opportunities part itself, the made in India, the domestic content requirement, Adani, by our target is by 2020 to generate close to 3 gigawatt of our own solar panels production. And we already broken into the 12th position, breaking into global 15 solar power developers. Because of the Prime Minister's digital drive, is it not, this is just a thought, which food for thought for everybody. If the billing is possible at every month, generate automatically and DISCOM just sends the bill, I mean, our money is credited, that would be better off. Rather than what's right now happening is I need to go there, get them, both like in our case, there are two agencies, to do the billing cycle and then, you know, joint signatures. Because it's not possible, technology is there. Then why can't we have auto billing sort of thing? Only in case of any controversy raises, then I go to them and go for a dispute or something like that. So, next is, as I said, about the net-centric operations. Ethernet is there. It's possible, like RONC, as I spoke about, is going to be the game changer for us. And let's see how Baba Ramdev pans out. He's already in with 100 crores of rupees of investment in Noida, as you're all aware. And news like this keep coming in every other day, the increase in the duty prices. But we look at it as an opportunity rather than this thing. And as you know, the sun shines, make hay. And it's a big cake, it's pie for everybody there. The future is bright and disruptive, whoever makes it. With that, thank you.